Hey guys, welcome back. In the second part of this seascape painting tutorial, I will show you now how I painted this part here. So, you better stay tuned. I'm Toby. This channel here is all about showing you how to draw and paint. So, make sure you hit the subscribe button here not to miss any new episode. So, we basically go in with a thicker layer of color for the underpainting, which is basically at the same time the first real layer of color. And you see it's pretty thick color, just to get this white of the background covered, fully covered. See me here putting in this greenish color here, greenish grayish color here. And that's just how it was on the reference material. The water on the near the shoreline here and here. I basically reworked the part between the sea and the cloud part here. And the trick with the tape is just brilliant, I think, very easy. And as this is a pretty rough sea that we have to paint here, you need to put in lots of reflections. And even at the background, as you can see, here now I am dry brushing on the next layer of color, starting to build up the waves here. And here I already put in some white water, breaking waves here. And make sure that they are not too harsh. They need softer edges at a far more distance. This here is now a bit of a lighter bluish color here for the reflections on the water here. You see me building it up gradually, step by step. Also with the dry brush technique here. And waves have the tendency to come in a line more or less. So you basically build up the line of waves here, also with the dry brush technique, carefully, and don't rush it, don't overdo it, and make sure you get in these variations, lighter tones, a bit darker tones. Now we work in the white water at the beach, and this looks white now, but it is far off, as you will see soon. So I put in here now the whitewater details and some waves that are breaking near the shoreline here. And this is now nearly a pure titanium white that I use. And this is just that you need to keep the tonal best for last, so to say, not to go in with the brightest color in the first try, in the first place. And of course a bit blending, dry brush blending more or less. And okay, in those details. Can see here building up this whole whitewater thing, and also building up the waves that break in the background, and this all needs some time to build it up. You need a lot of patience to do it this way, but I think it's the best way, because you can adjust the whole thing easier, I think. This part here is now the in-between, between the top of the incoming waves here, and there you want to have some reflections, at least here in the foreground.
just adding a bit more detail. As you can see, it's not a too bright bluish color here, bluish greenish color. And again, building up these whitewater parts here. And yeah, rubbing them in to get them nicely blended. Yeah. This is now the foreground detail part where you should put in even more details. Although this is a pretty big shot. We have no detail shot of the waves, but details are necessary, I think, for this step here. Even here, these fine little lines on the waves, on top of the waves here. And just get them in randomly. Don't use a pattern, but yeah.
Perhaps you might also like to check out one of these two videos here, and one of these is a water painting tutorial.